exhibiting here for the first time in Chandigarh are Jiten Thukral and Sumer Tagra. They have been invited by the Punjab Lalit Kala Academy to put a unique exhibition titled Farmer is a Wrestler, which resonates with all of us in today's time, with farmer protests across the country gaining ground, especially in Punjab. Both of them have a history of living in Punjab and in Chandigarh, and today they will share with us their journey working together and how they work in multidisciplinary arts, be it painting, sculpture, installation, and talk of today's time, which they feel that art should reflect the change and the times that we live in. Welcome to Punjab Lalit Kala Academy.
Thank you.
As you mentioned before, both of you, you have a strong Chandigarh connection, and it all began for both of you in Chandigarh. So if you could, we could start with the city that you're exhibiting in for the first time.
Hi, I'm Jiten Thukral.
Hi, my name is Sumer Tagra, and we are known as Thukral AND Tagra.
Yes.
And I think it is also that we are not just working on our own personal names, but we are working with as a family, as our given names.
Right.
As a family names. I think in 97 we met in Chandigarh College Park. You
okay.
Want to talk about that?
So it was, I was in third year in art college and he came to apply for the bachelor's. So it was one of a ragging session I met him. It was completely, we always say the God's plan. It was
yes.
Not in our hand. Neither we thought we'll work in whole life, and we have no idea like why we're meeting in Chandigarh. And I was standing outside the principal
office.
Room,
okay.
Office, so
okay.
Then he was there for applying the application. So this is how we interacted. So I say interact, not ragging in a way like that, but he said it was ragging. So, but then I came back to Delhi for my master's. Then he recognized me, he said, you were the person who ragged me.
Okay, so he never joined the
I never joined, yeah.
Okay.
I couldn't get through.
And you joined the Delhi College of Arts.
I joined Delhi College of Arts.
Interesting. And you later went for your
yes,
MFA.
Yes, I went for, after 1 year. I went to Delhi for masters.
And he was there.
He was there. He said, like, I am the studying. If you need anything, let me know. I said, but I don't know you. He said, hey, you ragged me in Chandigarh.
Yes.
So I remember, and he was like, I don't really remember you.
Obviously, he wouldn't the ragging
then
part.
Then the joke was, I used to rag a lot. It means, but not really. But
so what did you study in, what did you formalize?
I did my bachelor's
in
BFA in Bachelor in Fine Arts in Art College, in
okay.
Applied Arts.
In Applied Arts,
yeah.
Okay. And Jitin, you, where did you specialize in?
Sumer also did
Sumer,
it in.
Sorry.
I did it in College of Art, Delhi. I did Applied Arts. And then I went to NID for my master's.
Okay, for your design. Okay.
And then, but we were, while I was in Ahmedabad, I was in tandem with what he's doing. I think we actually started working over emails, and that's how it actually started, kind of had this idea of common sharing, common ideas, image banking,
okay.
And kind of visual dialogues where I, at that moment, the internet and the email attachments was very new. And then I would do something and send it to him, and he will do something and send back to me.
Okay.
So there was this idea of comfortability in terms of sharing the images,
right.
Rather than kind of protecting it.
Okay.
It started from there.
Okay.
But also very early on, I think it was more of making works rather than claiming that who is doing what.
Okay.
I think this is a very natural way to progress, and we both realized it very early on that. Yes, individually we have our own ideas to kind of execute, and then very soon we actually developed something which is more of a common aesthetics, common bank, common question centers, where he would like to inquire something and I would actually chip in with the inquiry, meaning that I can actually help him and then he can help me.
Okay.
So it's more of like it's more of this tossing of a ball, and it actually became an interesting practice because. For us, it has to be a very natural process.
What year was this, Sumit?
This is in 2002 to 2005. I'm talking about.
Okay. And this began with painting.
The first project which we did called the visual dialogue,
right.
Which he mentioned. So he will draw something in the morning and email me as an attachment image. So I'll work on the same image.
In your own
take
style,
it forward,
your
to
style.
Take it forward
and
right.
Multiply on the same image and send him back by evening.
So this was an informal way of working
yes,
together.
Yes, this was
yeah.
Informal way.
Okay, so you were just sharing at that moment
because
that
we were doing our own things, and
right.
these things become a little and a little like a cloud of escape, like, you know, let's do something which nobody tells me what to do.
Right.
And I would not write anything in the email, and he would just move on from there, and I will understand it and not delete it, but kind of build up. So it's basically like building up like a game.
Very interesting.
So we did 428 works in that duration of time of
just
one
with
and
an
half
exchange
years.
Of yes.
Just
emails.
With an exchange that he's doing something. I was working on how to kill yourself in 110 ways, 101 ways, and he was doing design is dead, I think. So he will shoot himself dead, and then we were like, hey, you know what? You and me both are working on the same thing, like, you know, a different way. I will really make really interesting, very cutesy drawings of killing our own self.
Why were you disillusioned, both of you?
No, I think we were kind of trying to move away from the system.
From the system, yeah. Break so away from the cliche. Yeah.
And then, but then had that breaking away had a very peculiar aesthetics because I chose something very different, and then he chose something very different, and we could see that he's shooting himself. Like, so the one of the image which I clearly remember is. He's shooting, so somebody shot from the top, and he on a staircase, when you move down, he's like lying down, and then there is a orange or a pink color blood on it.
It's not red.
It's not red, but kind of like a really pale salmon color, really juicy color, and kind of like flowing down through this gray, dingy staircase.
Yeah.
And when I actually saw that, I was like, oh, this color code is exactly like what I use.
Okay.
And so it's just, I think there's just images which talk to each other.
Right.
And also it bridged up a lot of gap because I was in Ahmedabad, he's in Delhi, so right. But then the distance didn't matter.
But did the design school change your perspective towards what you did at Delhi College of Art?
So the design school had its own ways of teaching. NID is very peculiar in approaching to sustainability or socialist idea of design. But in I think it was more advancing, but I kind of did not subscribe to everything.
Okay.
I was very keen on making my own ways of seeing, and I think I would, as I could be on the phone with him to kind of develop further more, I could actually find my own ways to see it, and I think that clubbed into what he was trying to do.
Right. And this must be very path-breaking in your time, Jitin, in the sense we're talking so many years back, because not many artists were experimenting with these kind of images and works, because painting was on the pedestal,
yes.
as
yes.
was sculpture. So was it breaking away from a lot
so
of... What were you doing at that time when he was at the design school?
When he was in design school, I was working in Bombay.
Okay.
For 6 months, I worked, 7 months, I worked in Bombay. But we were still in touch when that thing was happening. But when I came back to Delhi, I was working in an advertising agency.
Okay.
That also changed the perception.
Like right.
You just come out of the college and you work with the thing. And at the end of the day, you have to listen to somebody, whatever they want. Sometimes it is a problem-solving exercise, but it's not solving a problem because you have to listen to the liking and disliking of the particular person who wants that. Job to be done.
Absolutely.
So that become more of a rebel for us, both of us. So when he was studying in NID, most of the time he was here.
Okay.
Because of a lot of reasons.
Okay.
So then, so we were sitting together in the same office.
Same agency. Okay.
So like we had like did a lot of projects together. Like the first project when we mentioned visual dialogue.
Tell us a little about that, your first project together, visual dialogue.
So visual dialogue, one was done, we were doing unofficially, we did 428 pages, the works we created. Those
right.
So new media was very, kind of very in...
very enticing. Like, you know, you move into that thing that let's give away the analytical, the analog understanding of it, or hand drawn, but let's get on to the... to the interactive, to the mediums, to the design, which is to be done on a system.
Which sustains even till now in your
like
work.
Like, for example, how the music react to the work of art.
Right.
You know, or the work is based on the music. But, but we were creating digital works. We were not creating as a physical work. And we were participating. We were like, everybody do exhibitions as a... we can easily take a print of that particular digital work.
So easy ho jata hai to
so
reach out.
Because we said like painting, everybody's doing it. You know, it was very easy.
I mean,
we learned painting from art school.
And then we moved away from it to a point where we actually thought that this is the new medium. And I think when both both of us actually felt that how can we actually do justice, and this is very easy to say now to kind of understand it.
I agree.
But at that moment of like when you have to sustain, you're actually you have no support system from the government. There is very few institutions who can actually look into this thing. It was very hard for us to maneuver this this question. Even I mean, we didn't even know this is known as an inquiry or a question. You know, It was more of like trying to break away, trying to do something every day, every day. It's more of like, you know, you're trying to just make something new.
You're right, and create a space for yourself.
Yeah, for yourself.
Which,
it was like we didn't know about categories. We didn't know how disciplines will matter. So we kind of translated from, I mean, both of us have a very similar but kind of like a very interesting background where I learned my drawing from my mother.
Okay.
That's my first institution.
Okay.
And Jitin's father still runs a design studio in Jalandhar.
Really?
So he's been painting sculptures. Everything.
Okay. He's been doing things from last, what, when he was eighth standard.
Okay.
You know, like, you know, handling people also, like, it's also commercial design teaches you a lot of pressure.
Yes.
How do you maneuver? How do you
meet deadlines?
Yeah, how do you meet deadlines?
Yeah.
You know, it's not, it's a tough, it's a very tough space to perform your artistic journey.
And sometimes very consumer centric as well.
Yes,
yes.
Because you're constantly catering to an audience you may not connect with.
Like,
yeah.
So how do you kind of make your own artistic build up?
Absolutely.
Within the complexity of this, this transaction.
Yes, yes.
And for me, it was more of that, that you, started working very early on, and I could actually understand that, okay, so this is the area where I'm really comfortable with.
Okay.
You know, if I can't talk, I can draw. So these are the kind of commonalities which we kind of started sharing. I think it's also like when we exhibited in, I mean, you were coming onto that point of when we started exhibiting, the first thing was like, we don't want to subscribe to anything new.
Okay.
We want to know what we know, you know, we want to go down, because I think working in design industry and in advertising especially is a very superficial approach to do things, because they won't allow time. Things takes time to make. You know, you need
and
to
develop
food.
It further.
Yeah,
yes,
you cannot just keep Maggie every time, you know. You have to like really go down to a point where you need to really cook it well.
Right.
And that time is not given in an industry.
Right.
You know?
True.
I think both of us suffered that very quickly, that we were like, okay, I want to do this, but how do I do justice if I have to give it day after tomorrow?
Yes.
Like it needs good 6 months or at least 2-3 months to develop and kind of brew. I think that was really one of those things which we early on understood, that if we really need to dwell or process this thing, we need to buy time for ourselves.
Okay.
That is the only space which is an artistic space. And
but the good part was our seniors working in advertising, they were able to understand us.
Yes.
They were giving us freedom, what we can do, and they understood what we are doing and what we can do.
Okay.
They never stopped us.
Hmm.
We did a lot of body of work, and we said we want to publish a book.
Okay.
We took a help from these people, and book was published of 428 pages.
Wow. What is it titled?
It called One. It was a 1-inch by 1-inch book.
Okay.
It's a
cube book.
It's a cube book, small size.
Okay.
So we used to joke and say we should carry our portfolio in a pocket. Like, because there was no, as such,
digital.
There were no iPads, there's no technology you can show to anybody. Everything was hand tactile, the book.
Yes.
So we used to carry pocket and the portfolio. So what you do, this is our portfolio. You know?
Okay.
So that was our first, the book was published on our work, published by us only.
Okay.
We took a help from the different people. So it was a very interesting point for us to experiment from a digital media to coming to the analog as a physical copy of that.
Right.
And plus, after that we did another project called Visual Dialogue.
Okay.
That was in not only we working together, Hawk and Noel, or different writers, different photographers, to put them all together and make a one body of work.
Okay.
So somebody was in Bangalore, writer, one person was in Bombay, he went to Goa, he took some pictures, and somebody was in another person in, he was in Ahmedabad, I was in Delhi. So we all did together as a courier the physical CDs of the hard copy of the
images.
Okay.
So which traveled to all the people, so we can take a large print.
Interesting.
Then work was exhibited in 2012 in Japan, then went to London in one of the hype gallery in London. So
right.
It was like a for us was very encouraging for us as a submitting online your artwork.
Yes, yes.
So we our works were published more than 100 digital ways.
And we were kind of like known by our own names, like the first name.
Yes.
Sumer and Jitin. And then we thought that now, so when we actually, I mean, I'm just coming out to the first exhibition where actually we dropped a postcard at Peter's Gallery, Nature Mart. And we saw this Talur show and then we really liked it. We were like, well, wow, what a little interesting space. Hmm. And very clean and no nothing. And that was like the first gallery we actually really like felt comfortable that this is our kind of thing. And we dropped a postcard, we really liked your gallery and do visit our work. And then he mailed, we never checked the email because we had using like a couple of email accounts. And after like 25 days or something, in one of the exhibitions, Jitin met him and he dropped the postcard. And he was like, okay, you're the same people I've been looking for.
Okay.
And come and meet me, then show me what you've been doing. I really like the t-shirts and I really like a couple of stuff, come. So then he called me, he was like, okay, this American guy is asking us to come and meet. I don't know what he wants, but let's go and see it. I was like, don't waste time, let's just do your things. And we just landed up in meeting him. There was this Pushmala show happening in HMART.
Okay.
And we met him, it was sunny, it was winters and we didn't have space, so we stood in the kitchen and showed the image of the website. And Peter looked at it, he enjoyed it, and then he was like, okay, I'm doing a group show, would you like to be a part of it? We were like, okay, I mean, we don't mind. We really didn't know what is the big deal about it. And we thought like, okay, just another thing, like we're doing making works, we'll make another one. And he gave us the space after 10 days or 15 days when we met him again. And then we changed the entire space into something. So we were like, can we bring more things here? They were like, just don't burn the space.
Yes.
Do whatever you want to. We were like, okay, fine. And we could not stop making because we were like, this is also potential. Yeah, yes. This can also happen.
Right.
So
right.
I think it was a burst of ideas. It all came together. And we made an installation and somehow he liked it a lot. And but he could not sell it or he could not. He was like, there is a lot of energy. And if you can catapult it or kind of constrain it into one object,
okay,
I can help you shaping this.
Right.
And and we were like, yeah, if you want us to exhibit, we want to have a little space. Give us 3-4 months. And then we made first work, which was skin one.
Okay.
It was painting, it was an imagery of a grass. And he really loved it and he offered a show.
Okay.
And within three and a half, 4 months, I think we've made 6 paintings. I think, and then we just went to a shop and bought huge canvas. We thought, let's both of us start working. And that's the reason of a big size canvas started.
So okay. We both can stand and sit and work
and
together.
And then we composed the images on, on computer and projected it and started drawing. And it took us like, what, 25, almost a month to finish one painting. And then when we showed him the real flesh, like the real painting, and he really liked it. He was like, okay, why don't you do a group show, like a little space. So we made 6 works. That's
okay.
How it is.
So that was the first show happened in
2005.
Wow. And this is 2019.
And the first work was started with the installation-based works.
Yeah.
But India, a lot of people doing installation art, but as collector as such, they were not buying as installation art on that time.
No.
So then
it was really tough for us to kind of like, how do we address? Because also I think, it's also like, when do we stop? Like, you know, there is a painting, of course, there is no space beyond whatever we wanted to say. But when it comes to physical space, there is human behavior, interaction, proper way of displaying it, sizes, sound, temperature,
right.
Time of the day, taste.
Hmm.
So how do you kind of cater everything? And an object sometimes fails to cater all of it. Maybe it doesn't really have to.
No, yeah, I agree with you.
And I think we were very sensitive to these things that but then when the person comes in, what is he supposed to do? Just look at the painting and go? And we were like, no, maybe there should be a sound and maybe we should make an attention cartography.
Okay.
So, like, you know, so these are the kind of like ideas which developed.
But how easy or difficult is it to do collaborative work which is so close, because I'm sure both of you have your own ideas. And do sometimes is there a clash of ideas, or no? You found a way to enhance each other's.
I think we, but of course, it still it happened. I mean, till yesterday night it was happening. I think no. But the point is that if we kind of like take a step back from this idea of that maine bola ye aur tumne ye bola,
of course,
you know, then we are actually like, I think the point is that here we are trying to make a huge building,
right?
So it doesn't matter which brick has been put by whom,
completely,
but also the idea is that we are aware that the brick should not fall, and it should be stay there forever, you know?
Right.
And then how does a person walks around and he should not even get to know who has done what?
Yeah.
You know, that's the point of a collaborative or a partnership.
Exactly.
So he used a term, so the idea is owned by time.
You know, it is not owned by us. It is that moment in time which actually lets us perform.
Right.
So I think both of us were very aware of it, but we didn't know how to speak this. So very recently we understood that, so somebody asked exactly like who owns the time, who owns your ideas, like you or both of you, which one? I was like, maybe the time owns it, because we would actually say in 2005 we did that.
Yes.
That's so the right. Only thing we remember.
True. So is there a blueprint before a work that this is how it's going
a
to
lot.
Be?
Yeah.
If you could talk a little about the process that goes into, because your works are so different, in every work is unique and multidisciplinary, and somehow there is no repetition. It's amazing that be it idea, be it style, be it treatment. I was just reading about some of your works as well. So what makes you, how do you do this? Is there a bank of, of course, a lot of your work is related to what the times that we live in, and you also say that art should reflect that. Mm. So how does it happen?
Jitin, you want to say?
I think every project, I'm going to use the word project.
Yes.
Why? Because he is artist, what as an artist going through right now.
Bilkul.
Migration
tha, Indian mythology tha, ab Punjab ka crisis hai, farmer crisis hai. So, बहुत चीजें रिफ्लेक्ट होती हैं सिर्फ एक एस्पेक्ट नहीं तो
सो आई विल गोइंग टू टॉक फ्रॉम द फर्स्ट शो वी डिड इन नेचर मोड सो दैट्स द एंड अनदर थिंग इज एवरी आइडिया रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय डिफरेंट मटेरियल एंड डिफरेंट प्रोसेस एंड टेक्निक सो वी इवन व्हेन द फर्स्ट वर्क वी डिड ऑफ द व्हेन यू सेड वी डिड अ विजुअल डायलॉग दैट वाज फॉर अस इट वाज अ टेक्निक एज अ मीडियम नॉट एज अ व्हाट वी आर ट्राइंग टू से अबाउट दैट You know, that was the first exploration of a lot of ideas, put them together and make a different language altogether. But visual dialogue was a medium of that. So like the first show when we showed Peter the painting, but in that whole exhibition, there were photographs overlaid with the drawings and the illustration in silk screen on the top of it.
Okay.
That work was based on 84 riots actually.
Okay.
So it talks about the underground movement happening in Punjab in 2005. The lot of underground music was being popular.
Yes.
And the stickers on the cars were changing.
Yes. True.
From number plates to the house plates to the people attitude towards that and the sound. So then those music was banned later on in Punjab and in UK especially, because those were coming from UK who migrated from India.
Haji. True.
So those works were based on that. But the context when those works are put in Delhi in an exhibition, they were not able to relate.
I mean, it was tough for us to actually even share this process or this concern. I think I can I take it
yeah,
from there.
Please.
So no, though I think what he was trying to also say that that every project shapes into a point where we know the concerns, but we may not share the completely. We don't really sometimes able to address it in totality.
Okay.
You know, it is hard for us to sometimes to kind of grasp it all. And what is our position in that? What is our artistic agency in using this? So I think we are actually growing in this inquiry a lot.
Okay.
Our own self, like all the failures, people don't see the failures, people see it as beautiful painting. And this is how they really do it. But there are a lot of failures which we actually saw. And we are very very fragile about these things, that we could not address that. I think by every project which we actually did, so we thought that we will do this project until unless we say whatever we wanted to say. the moment we finished that, we were not, if I'm revisiting, I'll say more, but I don't want to repeat the same thing.
Okay.
So one thing is that that's why we never repeated. A lot of artistic processes are completely about meditative and repetition.
Yes.
Which is fine for them.
Right.
For both of us, we just can't, because we evolve every day. I don't think so that can hold up to the execution. You know what I'm trying to say?
Yes, yes.
But that doesn't mean that we have to be like a butterfly hopping from it and everything. I think it is to a point where we address it, we develop it, we bake it to a point when we have to say it, we say it. So there are like four projects multi at the same time we are actually doing.
Really?
So there is one thing with the play and pray, with this idea of mythology and the act of play. One is this idea of escape, which is to do with our hometown, which is Punjabis, leaving the town and moving out. What are the aspiration value, what are the family changes for the dialect, food, taste, environment, their social structures, their mental health, the physical spaces adapt into different forms. And then at the same time, what are we passing on to the next generation?
Okay.
That's the most so. From that point, the educational pedagogical understanding comes in. Now, we're very importantly kind of working, developing in-house sort of a systems to kind of counter this idea of education which become pedantic or not been seen as an active, evolved approach to educate.
Right.
At the same time, both of us are very aware that we have to leave things for a lot of people to come in. We can't be self-obsessed about our own projects.
Okay.
And I think we learned it pretty much early in 2009. We set up our own foundation, which actually goes to grassroots level people and talk about what we are actually doing. And it is very simple, one idea at a time, and then it moves into spaces. So
by that you mean that you involve other people
yes.
as part of the
so
foundation in
yes.
your artistic
yes.
endeavors?
Yes. So those are some certain projects are there.
Right.
Even we are not there on this
right.
world. The projects can still sustain with involving people, audience, and
oh.
can sustain.
So
as
we both don't have to be there today. We are sitting here, and our studio girls are actually in Bombay setting up a space.
Okay.
And that is a very different challenge.
Yes.
Because we were always doing hands-on, setting things. So now, like, we've started trusting people. And people have started trusting us.
They're and these are all young artists who you're
young,
working with?
Yeah. So these girls are researchers within our studio. And we wanted that we will exit from this project from now. And you will take care of it.
Oh, so it gives them
gives
so
them an authority.
Of,
give
yes.
them, we empower them to kind of develop this thing on their own. And this is how, and everything has been defined, aesthetics is defined. So if we die tomorrow, the projects can continuously move around in different forms. So we've already done in four cities. So there are three projects like this.
Okay.
Then we started making game designs.
Yes, I've read about that, but I didn't understand much about how does game design enter your art and how, of course I understood that it is interactive. It involves the public in your art, but how does it happen?
So very briefly, I will just explain in one sentence that the game theory is embedded in our lives very interestingly. The act of getting in the morning and going to the school, coming back, eating food.
Okay.
This entire thing is process cueing. It's
right.
a technical word. But if you kind of like deconstruct it, what it teaches you that we have been conditioned to do certain things. You know,
absolutely.
Like every day you will get up, your body will tell you because it has been trained like that.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
So
I never thought of it like that.
Yeah. So if now, the thing is that we actually just wanted to kind of be more aware of these things. Like somebody just said, I think eating together makes a bond. So if you just, agar aap kisi ajnabi ke saath khana khate hain, to dosti ho jati hai. Well, that moment is a very... It's a very honest memory which builds up.
Okay.
And you can revisit it. But when you play a game with it, it is much more faster.
Mm.
It is even more better bond. Because you're just not using that moment of togetherness to eat or kind of to settle yourself by whatever, hunger. You're actually trying, you know, when you play, you open up your fragility, you open up your power. And you that display of this honest opinion about an act of play within 20 minutes or 1 hour will reflect what you are up to.
Okay.
You know, if you see people playing football, you will understand what is the muscle and what is the mind.
Right.
So it's that.
Interesting.
So with that action, we started developing many interesting ways of seeing a project.
Okay.
Also, with that desire that people should spend time in the exhibition space, a simple,
you know, like as a simple fact, it's not about how much time people spend looking at the artwork. And the museum says 3 seconds per artwork.
That's it.
That's it.
Wow.
And we went with the project. I mean, it is not a counter to a 3 second investigation.
No, of course not. Of course not.
But
the idea is to address what we are doing is, and people should consider and look at and try to understand what we're doing. I know art is a very coded language, you know, it's not there. But how can we make it more accessible to everyone?
That's
so it's
point.
Not made for the niche or who come into the gallery or for the students or for the art people. No.
Yes.
It should be for everyone.
Completely.
I mean, the word inclusive
has
a responsibility to it.
Right.
If we don't make it inclusive, what are we working for and who we are working for?
Absolutely, because so many times people are almost afraid to step into a gallery.
Yeah.
Yes. There's so many times where people have asked me, "Hum dekh sakte hain?"
Yeah. There is so, this social
which is very disheartening because this is for us. I mean, this is for common people like us.
Yeah, and we don't really have to subscribe to a visual. Yes, of course.
Yeah.
One can develop it and peel off a little more if he's aware of.
For sure.
But that doesn't mean that it is if a young mind or an inexperienced mind can enjoy or savor it, you know.
Yes. So how important is it for both of you that people understand your art?
It's both ways. It is equally more challenging for us to kind of develop more curatorial, more critical analysis of a work, but also at the same time keep it as honest and as humble.
Yeah, humble is a word that I was looking for.
Yeah.
That this is deliberate. This is deliberate.
Want people to come and touch the artwork.
Yes.
Not strictly.
Not
the painting.
I was very tempted.
Yeah.
You know, because it gave you a feel that I wanted to touch it.
So if you go downstairs, they were the small paintings were actually meant for people to they can come.
Okay.
They can change the artwork. They can make their own combinations with the work.
As a part of work.
But right now, we're not allowing for this particular exhibition because
in
the opening day is very difficult. Yeah. And we are not a museum. They are not a...
No.
It's
but
not
you have...
A,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
But there are like a lot of projects that we have did where the games are there. People come and interact with the play on table tennis. They touch the sculpture and they get a feel of... They're allowed to touch the sculpture.
They can touch it.
And take a picture with that. So they are part of the sculpture.
Okay.
So audience finishes the piece.
You know, there are
not...
So there are like interesting when you said that. There are interesting ways to kind of operate. Sometimes it is come and participate and finish the work of art.
Okay.
So this is known as open formats of the project. Sometimes it is just a part of the experience where you don't really touch it, but be a part of it as being present. So there is a show going on in Delhi right now. So when we actually want people to just walk around it or through it to experience this gust of 14 fans, air which hits you.
Okay.
And it feels that the air or the technology changed it into a sea breeze.
Interesting. Lovely.
So there are interesting ways to kind of interpret this question.
Right.
But for both of us, I think more interesting is that people should really be comfortable in the space rather than being you're not in a court that you're getting investigated like many museums have that approach and
feel you get sometimes,
you know, there is this cold air around you,
right?
But and why we don't really have to use extraordinarily critical words to build up the discourse, you know, we can be very humble and approaching to normal audiences and still having the meat and material in it.
Absolutely.
You know?
And what you want to say, your own philosophy.
Yeah.
Which brings me to a point that a lot of flowers and architecture also enter your works.
Yeah.
Is it been influenced by the cities that you have lived in, Punjab as well as Delhi, and also your travels across the world?
Yes. It is it's a very simple, it's a dream house, Dominus Aeris we call it, it's in Latin. The house in the air or the flying houses. It's also a very simple imagery of a dream sequences, which we try to do. Also, one thing which we wanted to kind of add on, that we didn't want to have any gravity in the work.
Okay.
They flow as bubbles.
Yes, yes.
And they can be seen as a slice of a film eventually when we finish or whatever.
Right.
So
That is the...
Yeah, that's the continuity.
And how difficult is it to work with so many different mediums and textures and forms? Is it deliberate, or you feel the need that all these, be it video, be it painting, sculpture, installation, films, so you feel that you need to use all these mediums to talk?
It depends on what we are working on, what kind of material required for the particular.
Okay. So it's not that.
If it can be represented by the film, then we go for the film. If it's it should be interactive as a game. Like for right now, we're working on a farmer's issue you're talking about.
Yes, let's talk a little about that.
So then, it's very easy to make a painting. People come and see the film, what the farmer is going through. Then they see the painting as the artist's interpretation of the work.
Okay,
this is a distress equation of the going on. This is the equation of the farmer. How can we make them experience what farmer is going through? They just go online and order food. Or as everybody do that now, but the food comes to your plate. But how much effort went through the thing, and what problems other person is going through? As I'm talking about metro cities, who are sitting, everybody is ordering online food. So it's not against that system, but when the audience comes to the show, see the body of work, film or a thing, can he lie down on the floor and touch those points which farmer is going through?
Mm.
You know, can he experience that pain of,
like,
the other person?
Can somebody invest this energy, this elite urban class energy of going to a museum, buying a ticket and sipping a Starbucks coffee, and to kind of, from that position, that authority, he can invest a sincere approach to at least understand
what is going through. Yes.
So what we did was, one of the project is which is still in developing right now, is a project where it is a court, and you are supposed to kind of physically touch those pointers. Every pointer is an issue of farming. When you touch in a way, you make an equation which talks about a problem, which is can be seen as the loans, the debt, and then the seeds, and then the climatic conditions.
Absolutely.
And then the low MSP, which leads to suicide.
Yes.
So this simple understanding, so there are simple equations like this,
right,
which can be interpreted like when you actually touch your knees, your toes and your body and your shoulder, and then the moment you touch and hold on for 10 seconds, you literally are kind of like trying to feel the pain.
Right.
That doesn't mean that it is, it's just some kind of a effort which we wanted to kind of bring out. And then on the exit, you have a certificate to reward your own self about levels of sincerity. Then how much sincerely you actually did. So there is no competition, and we're not standing there. So these are the open formats where we want people to kind of, we will make the platforms and we will make the systems and we will want the instructions. And people just walk around with their own experiences and let them do whatever they want to do.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And I think both of us are very keen on making this idea of play, or this idea of investing or launching games into this kind of an environment where it has been very restricted, or kind of like you walk in from A to B to C and then move out. We would want them to kind of revel around and...
Right. So where did this exhibition...
This will be in Yorkshire Sculpture Park.
Right, which is coming up in October.
Yeah.
But the starting point is from the
Chandigarh. From this exhibition, yes. When did this exhibition, and why did it... has it been playing on your mind for many years now, the farmers?
Diwan has been talking to us for more than 6 years. He's been telling us, let's do a show here. And
The project of the farmer is a wrestler.
Yes.
Where did that emerge from? From Punjab?
From Escape.
No, it came from Escape. So we were doing the Punjabi diaspora. We were working from 2006 on this project on diaspora.
It's called?
The Escape project.
Escape
for Dreamland or Escape.
Okay.
The Escape project. So the Escape project started in 2006. We started documenting the houses in Punjab.
Okay.
The beautiful houses which has airplanes on the top. Sorry?
The old
the
houses?
The one with the
water tanks.
Yeah.
So we've been documenting from 2006.
Okay.
And we started painting around 2000. We've been documenting from 2003.
Okay.
We started painting those houses in 2006.
Okay.
So it's a very, it's a long journey towards that. From more than 10 years of work went to that. So then we start doing research, when you start meeting those people personally, why the houses are abandoned, okay. Where are they, where the money comes from,
right.
They've come, all of them come from agricultural land, they sell the land, they get the visa, they
yeah.
make the house to prove
yeah.
to their peers they have reached somewhere, but they don't live in the house.
Yes.
So how the culture changes according to that. So now those houses leads, then we were working, and my family owns a akhada in Jalandhar.
Akhada?
Yeah.
Okay.
So where the wrestlers coming
right,
in.
Right, right.
So that's
kushti.
My kushti. Yeah. So that's, we that's my dad's three friends own the akhada, was
okay.
given to them. They don't, we don't own as a land,
right.
So
but
the
they run the,
like running,
right. running
right.
the space to still keeping the tradition alive.
Right.
So we've been going there and doing a lot of different projects every year there. As for how can we involve the more community?
Okay.
You know? So where those people also come from? As or most of them come from farming actually.
Right.
Also, so we're bringing them together and talk about as a farmer's issue from the wrestling point of view.
Hmm.
Again, come from the game theory comes in between.
Okay.
So this is our starting point of the point of view of the addressing the issue as an artist for farmers.
Right.
You know? So we work with, we did consult with a lot of different organizations, Badu Sahib organization
yeah, yeah.
in from Badu Sahib.
Right.
They helped us to go and meet the farmers who did suicide or how
okay.
they are helping, they're changing the lives of farmers. So it was very interesting for us to address the issue.
Right.
It, there we are coming from. So we've been working on this project for more than 3 years.
Okay.
We've been involved in this system from 7 years particularly.
That's a long
but
time.
Working one-to-one directly from last 3 years, we've been research on this. And we went to Sangrur village and Sangrur side, and we went to the Haryana, the side where the problems are more active.
Right.
Live, talking about that. Then you want to add on?
Yeah, I mean, see, it's very easy for us to, I mean, or not for us, but these to find out these things and to go and click pictures and come back and show them as an exhibition. Okay. It's
yeah.
But then how do you change it? How do you, you know, so we have lots of data which we don't want to show.
Okay.
Because we don't think so that is, for us it is, it's a very interesting emotional kind of encounter that we didn't know what to say. We did not click a picture. When we were talking to a family which this guy passed away last year,
okay.
a year, within a year. So the moment we landed up, all the kids got his photograph. You know, that's how, because everybody goes there and do this.
Yes.
And we were very upset with this thing. We were like, no, don't bring the photograph. I mean, but he actually got in, he's holding, the woman is holding the photograph of his late husband in her lap. And then we could not talk.
Mm.
And we somehow kind of like spend a little more time to understand what is it. So they started showing us the passports, their
passbooks.
Passbooks.
Then how much money did you see? Just see it, and we were very like we were five people and kind of like we shut the camera. We were like we can't address this way.
Yes,
it needs to be addressed in a very interesting kind of. We need to bring up something, which, and then we that same day we could not really understand what has happened.
It
was too
it.
Much.
Hmm. Hmm.
Thinking about those things, we actually thought that let's just do, I'm just confused what to say and what not to say.
We went there to meet those families. We went with full energy. We're going to take the pictures. We're going to interview them.
Okay.
We went the whole team standing there. We couldn't take one picture.
Okay.
Our researcher, who did research for 2 years only on this crisis, we had it more than some 7,000 pages of research
God.
As a docket.
Mm.
When we reached to the family to meet the real person in life, not sitting in the AC chamber
yes.
as a...
And reading about statistics that every 41 minutes, one farmer kills,
yes, kills himself. Yeah.
So saying it is different.
Yeah.
The moment you reach to that house where she will show you, this is the fan he hung himself. It's insane.
Yes.
Like
I,
you have no idea how to kind of like say a word.
The
yes.
guy, 50,000 bucks for the loan, 80,000 rupees for the loan.
Mm.
Now imagine.
And there's a list of people. I mean, we have it with us. We don't want to show it. I mean, we can show it, but don't want to show it as an exhibition, which says how the guy killed himself. So electric shock, hanging, train, tractor. It's insane. Like the moment you kind of see that, you were like, okay, this is too much. I don't want to even read it again.
Yes.
Because it kind of like it questions your own privilege, your own understanding where you're so comfortable, like to ask light nahi, aaj mere ko neend nahi achhi aayi. Like what are we talking about?
Yes.
And who are we in sitting in like in all kind of well made clothes to kind of go there in our car, in our gadi, to kind of visit and kind of like talk to them about this thing? It's ridiculous.
Right.
But we also very guilty about this and very privileged. We understand our kind of understanding of, but how do you address it in an exhibition? How do you kind of use this as use that failure of our own system? That how do we interpret it? So, I mean, we are still tackling that.
Right.
And we are very aware that whenever we are doing the exhibition, we need to address that as a forefront of it rather than just making objects out of it. So that I got inspired by her death. I mean, like, what ridiculous way to say it.
Right. So will this be an ongoing project, like you're exhibiting here in Chandigarh? Will it change when you go somewhere else, or will it be there'll be additions to this? Is there a format like that? Or
so there will be. I mean, there will be different formats. We don't want. We want to address the issue.
As
this like an open discussion.
Okay.
As in, I put as a question to public, because and now they come and interpret it from themselves what they think about it, and it could be the point of discussion. You know,
okay.
They come and let's talk about this. Why this issue is here? You know,
okay.
Just addressing an issue from an artistic point of view. But so when we were doing research, we were not meeting those people who already done help, who already suicide happened.
Hmm.
What? How can they save more people?
Yes.
In the same community.
Right.
I mean, we can't go physically solve them, but we can do. But we met different scientists from Punjab who say we can save actually.
I mean, if these are the things are problem, but if they really understand it, it can be treated. But that interest and investment of time, education is hard to kind of being that given to everybody. You can actually do a task force. You can do 5 people, you can do 10, but it cannot actually change entire community. And that will take a really long time. It'll be too late by that time. But then this is how we are actually like in the middle of the process. So the exhibition in in Yorkshire, which is kind of like why we actually landed up doing this here, is because of that query, space, is titled as Bread Circus and TET, which is to be decided. The exhibition title talks about the to be decided, to be determined, because we are also in the flux, we are also in the movement of this.
Mm.
So for the first time, we thought that we should not use color in the painting. So the painting is empty.
Okay.
And we want people to fill the colors, like literally in their own head.
Mm.
If you see the exhibition, there are areas which are left white.
Yes, sir.
This is for the first time. We actually stopped the process in between. It's a transitional understanding of the work, not completely finished, because when we finish the painting, it is my dream, which I finish. I don't subscribe you, your inputs then. I just want you to see my dream.
Right.
So there are paintings which are complete.
Yes.
But there are halfway left, so that there is a potential to grow. Even if there was this paintings called pinballs.
Mm-hmm.
We made 12 paintings. With half and a half, you can actually join as a performative element.
Okay.
But we displayed only 4.5, because we displayed one and then 4 of them as half pieces, as that it's to be made.
Okay. Still to be.
Yeah, still to be determined.
Right.
And the way it is executed is also that you can actually shift the stories, but then the soul remains the same of the painting.
Nice. Interesting. So does every work begin with a painting or a drawing?
See, now this is very interesting, because we have to make money and we have to basically manifest our ideas in totality.
Hmm.
Painting is for sketching or drawing is the first thing where we don't really have to go to a third party.
Right.
Where we need to execute something. So a painting which is a melting iceberg turned into a person who's a sculpture, which is a frost sculpture, where the ice gets accumulated on it. The frost, and then he freezes and changes the expression.
Oh.
And then suddenly a power cut will happen, and the power will change it to a sweat.
Right.
And it is just a very simple kinetic electronic like electrical
what game. You have displayed yeah. in chairs.
Yes.
Yes, I saw that. Okay, yes. So that is the concept.
Moment you enter, there's the Swaminathan report is here.
Yes.
You know, like which we've been talked from last 10 years. It has to implement.
Okay.
So like it is a very simple drawings of a wrestler.
Right.
You know,
yes,
and
yes.
using that as a reading room to begin with.
Yes.
So
yes.
you open
there. There is so much text there
yeah.
which I want you to
yeah.
quickly you
so
know.
So that is Swaminathan report, and we have a table where all the reports are kept there.
Mm.
And there is a synopsis also. You can read it online. It is free, available. We use that as a sketch pad.
Yes.
And made a lot of drawings of it, and then thought that the display should look like a library setup. Of library of kind of unresolved questions and things which have been given and we have never been seen. We installed a light bulb and you sit around it and kind of read about it and also see the documentation of Kisan Mukti Morcha, which we were a part of on 29th and 30th of November last year. There was 1 lakh people all across from the country. There was no news.
No. Yes.
So this is
they were talking about 30,000 policemen were there,
yes.
but they never talk about how many farmers were there.
So
yes.
you know, so how we actually twist and turn about the situations.
Right.
Plus also at the same time, we move on to the reality from reality box. We move into the dream, to the actual analysis, and then in the dark room is the dream sequence. So there,
right.
and
so
then you basically
yeah.
you dip down, go to the last room and come back from the scene.
So it's many layers and elements
yeah.
that,
yeah.
but you're living in times where artists are called artists now and not painters and
yeah.
sculptors. So is it a good time now for?
It's a tough time.
Really?
Yeah, it's tough because it's tough. At the same time, it has many options to.
Is it more liberating?
It's
now
more
than when you began. In terms of artistic expression, selling, I don't know. I
no,
mean, with your
saying,
kind
no,
of work,
I'm telling,
I,
yeah, no,
I'm
we,
sure it's it must be a different challenge altogether.
We survived. I think there is a very interesting thing because we actually saw the changing of the internet of
yes.
this thing. It was our time
right.
that we started in a very basic understanding of it and also now executing it into this fast-changing moment.
Yes.
That's a very interesting way to see it because we also see that we can gel between the millennials and also the people
yes.
who have been completely analog in their life.
Yes, our generation has been very lucky in that
yes.
sense to have seen it all, actually.
To seen it all.
Yes, yes.
And to at least see this change. And when we are actually with the younger people, we see there is a lack of, not skill, I would say, lack of concentration, like lack of
focus.
Discipline.
Focus. I agree with you, completely.
It's a very interesting time. I don't know if it is tough or not. Okay. Never been really reached kind of to toss it. But I think for both of us, it has opened many new potential. Like we want to work with grassroots level.
Right.
We want to work with projects which are completely based on digital archiving.
Okay.
Plus also at the same time, we want to work in art spaces which are kind of very problematic.
Okay.
And also in our studio with people who we are working with.
Right. So anything new that you'd like to, anything that is on your mind which you want to now in the future implement or execute which hasn't been, which is close to your heart?
I mean, we want to execute, I think the spaces we want to kind of do the exhibitions
okay.
in spaces which have been never been seen as a space.
Right.
I think that's more, we need to decentralize the institutional understanding of our work to be displayed. And I think that's most important for us right now.
Right. Thank you. It was wonderful to speak to you.
Thank you so much.
And we'll, of course, see you for the exhibition.
No, thank you so
we
much.
We address
thank
all
you.
The
you
issues
it.
From this show to put all together. I
yes.
think it works.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.